Hey guys, it's Monica at Academic Phoenix Plus, and welcome back. We are going to continue working on this piece. So far, we've created the chairs, the table, and we've even done some fur. The next part is actually rendering it in a way that looks nice. So I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this floor for now, and I'm going to show you guys how to create studio lighting for something like this. So what I usually do is go to the side view, and I go to Create. Curves, EP curve tool. And if you don't want to see this darkness, just go ahead and turn off your lights. And up here, I'm going to just go ahead and start holding down shift and clicking down so it gives me a straight line. And as I get closer to the models, I'm going to start arcing the ground. And I'm getting a little close to the floor, but that's okay. To the objects, I'll just create a straight line and then press enter. I'm going to move this down a little bit so it's actually ground level, making sure that line is going to be the floor. I'm going to right click on the curve, go to Control Vertex, select these, and by scaling it flat, you know that it's going to be, well, flat. So I'm going to grab these and do that. Same thing for this one. I'm going to press R and I'm going to crush it using scale, then go back to object mode. If you want to make any tweaks or changes, just right-click, go to Control Vertex, and then just go ahead and make some changes. For example, maybe I want this a little lower. So it's a good opportunity for you to alter your curve. Now let's go back into perspective. I'm going to move this to the side. I'm going to Control D, which is duplicate, and move that. And now I have two curves. Selecting these two curves, I am going to go to my tab called Curves and Surfaces, and there's this one called Loft. If you want to go the long way, you can always go to Surfaces and then hit Loft. It'll give you the same results. So what I get is an infinity curve. This is actually not geometry, this is a NURB surface. So if I right click, you'll notice that I have isoparms, hull, control vertices. It's basically geometry, but it's based on curves. Once I have that, let's go ahead and delete the history, freeze the transformations, and let's see what we get. Let's render. So what we get is what's called an infinity curve. This is very important for studio lighting. So for example, if you're trying to show off your stuff, you need to lift it up a little higher because you can see the shadows, they're all floating. But it creates this nice little gradient. So it's not a sharp line like a box or like a room, for example. This is more like to show off your studio lighting. So I think it looks really nice. Let's go to the glass shader. I'm gonna just rough it up a little bit so it doesn't look so perfect. I think some roughness might help a little bit. And the next thing is I don't really want a sky dome because that's outside lighting. Before I forget, let's move it up. What I want is studio lighting. So let's go to Arnold Light and I'm going to grab an area light. Bring it up. Now you can't see it because I hid my light. So let's go to show lights. So this is an area light and I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees. And whatever that little light is pointing down, you see the little line sticking out of the light? That is the direction of the light. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and scale it. And I'm also going to bring it up. Now, when I render, it's not going to really release that much light. All right, it's almost like there's nothing there. So I'm going to go and open up the attributes of the area light and turn off normalize. And now it will render with some light, which is great because that's exactly what we want. It's a little dark, so I'm going to go ahead and increase the exposure. And I'm going to make it a little bit longer so that it covers the environment from above. And then I'm going to do the same thing and create another light, another area light. So this time I'm just going to move this one to the left and scale this one up. Again, don't forget to turn off normalize. So when we render, you can see that we get some nice lighting from the left and also from the top. Now go ahead and stop that. Might as well close this. Let's do it again. We can actually just grab this light and duplicate it. Control D. Go to the other side and just rotate it 180 degrees. Again, we just want to make sure that it's far enough away so that it gives us good lighting. Double check to make sure normalize is turned off. And now we can see what it looks like. So as you can see, now we're getting some really nice highlights. We are getting some nice smooth lighting. Everything's basically looking exactly what we want, which is nice smooth lighting to show off our model in the best possible way. I still feel it's a little dark, so let's go ahead and increase the exposure. I'm gonna increase everything by exposure to 2. I might be too bright, but let's see what happens. So now we're really starting to see the lighting. Let me get closer. Let's get a nice shot here. Something like that, render. So what studio lighting does is that it gives us some nice soft shadows. We don't get sharp shadows. There's no direction the lighting's coming from specifically. It shows off the nice highlights. It basically has no real dark shadows anywhere. And it's just a nice looking render. Now you may be happy with this, but what I really want is to get a little bit, just push this a little bit further. So what we can do over here is grab this light and we can warm it up a little bit. So for example, I can make it a little bit yellow, just a touch. And on the left side, I can make it a little bit blue. Again, just a touch. Just enough to give this a little bit more color variance. So it's very subtle. Well, it's not that subtle, but it's a little bit subtle because you still get the nice look of the environment, but you also get some color variation so that it's not so boring and flat. So this gives it a lot more information and it also gives it a nice feel. All right, so I think the floor is too high. I'm going to bring it down a little bit. Or maybe the carpet's too low. Let me grab the disc, which is actually the fur. Lift it up just a tiny bit, just a hair, pun intended. Let's see what that looks like. I just want to make sure it doesn't look like there's Lambert below it. All right, so let's talk about noise. So anytime we have a render, we always want to talk about how noisy is this. This looks pretty good. I can zoom in a little bit more. The fur is looking nice. Everything's looking nice, but I really want to see is this area where the shadows are located, because we do have multiple, we have at least 3 lights. Well, we actually have 3 lights, and it's going to emit specific number of samples to create shadows. So right now the highlights, but you can see that the glass is, if I zoom in, you can see that the glass is a little bit noisy. And if I go over here, you'll notice that even the shadow is actually pretty noisy. Now I should let it finish, but these areas I've already completed, as you can see, as it starts rendering through this piece. You'll notice that, you know, you may be happy with the look, but to be professional, you really want to get rid of that noise. I'm going to let it finish rendering and then I'm going to take a look at the time. There we go. It just finished 1 minute and 14 seconds. So this only took 1 minute and 14 seconds, which I know to some may seem like a lot. It's not. I've done a lot longer renders, like 45 minutes, even longer, an hour and a half. In the industry, they're like days. But what I really want to do is smooth that noise. There's no way I want that. And also I need to fix the transmission. So there's a couple ways we need to do this. The first one is the actual lights themselves. They have samples. So in each, I usually increase my samples to 3. Now I only increase my samples after I'm done lighting. This is really important because this will slow down your render. So if you're trying to render and you have lighting and you're just testing things out, don't increase the samples because it's going to take forever to render. Just go ahead and increase your samples when you're done lighting. So once I'm done with that, I'm going to go to my render settings. I'm going to go to Arnold Renderer. Then I'm going to play around with my samples. I'm probably going to go up to 5, maybe even 6. I want to go any higher than that. I'll probably do 4. We do have specularity. We do have transmission. We don't really have subsurface, so I might drop that to 1. And we don't have light fog, so I'm going to turn that to 1. And there is an adapting sampling. I'm going to turn that on and just change that to like a 7. Some people go higher. It's really up to you. I don't want to go too high because then it will take forever. But adapting sampling means that it will take, it's pretty intelligent, so it's going to take its time and really evaluate certain areas at this high of a rate. Now remember, this value exponentially increases these. So the higher this number goes, the higher, the more samples is going to get. So just kind of keep that in mind. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and render. We're going to take a look at the noise. This is probably going to take longer than the other one, but we'll go ahead and let this scene render, and I will be right back and let you know how long it took. All right, it finally finished. It's about 8 minutes and 26 seconds, so it exponentially increased the render time. But look at the quality of the render, though. The glass is looking a lot clearer, still a little noisy. I could probably push it further. And then over here, whoops, we have the noise. It's still a tiny little bit noisy, but at the end, we have a really much nicer render. And that's why we increase our render settings. So hopefully you found this tutorial helpful. Let me know if you guys have any questions by leaving a message below. And don't forget to take a look at academicphoenixplus.com to take a look at free tutorials, free downloads like 3D models and ebooks and all sorts of stuff just for you. So take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. And also don't forget to subscribe and click on that little bell so that you don't miss any of my renders. In the next tutorial, what I'm going to do next is maybe add a little decoration here and also a couple of other pieces to push this forward. But overall, we've got nice lighting. We've got some nice pieces done. We did fur, leather, glass, a little bit of wood, and a great and beautiful lighting so that it renders nice and you have something for your portfolio. So thank you again for watching. Let me know if you guys have any questions, and I will see you next time.